And we are recording already. Yes, we are. What's up, everybody? Welcome back to the channel. Hope all of you are doing absolutely fine wherever you are. I know COVID spreading like wildfire all over the country, and all I can say is please stay safe, please be safe, spread awareness, spread as much of care and love as possible. Okay, without any further ado, I am pulling out the cycle for a ride, and I know I've not been vlogging for a very long time on the cycle, but I have been doing smaller rides, about say 15 kilometers, 20 kilometers, small rides just to stay in touch. And I thought today I will take you guys on one of those small rides. Okay, now this contraption that I am using right now is the Fujifilm XA7S. So I can't pull it out too much and like take you like throughout the journey, but I am going to stop and show you some of my best places that I like to cycle to. Okay, but first I am going to clean my chain up with the Moto chain cleaning lube over here that I have. So we are going to do that first, and then I'm going to lube my chain, and then we are going to set off on a small little trip. If you guys were standing here and looking at the way I was actually holding my camera, I'm telling you, it is absolutely ridiculous. I am holding the tripod between my knees, and is it tough or what? I actually have a neighbor peeping through his window to see what the hell is going on right now, but it's okay. If you keep thinking about what others are looking at, you're never gonna get anything done, man. Okay, so now that the chain cleaner has been applied, I'm just gonna let it sit for about 5 minutes. I have to be a little careful for the first couple of kilometers, because I'm gonna have a little bit of lube on the tire and on the wheel as well. You see all this little cutie hair? All this hair? That is my cat. I have two cats, by the way. One is Ice and one is Kiko. Ice is a Persian and Kiko is an Indie cat. So Ice gets his hair almost everywhere throughout the house. So by the time the chain cleaner does its job, I wanted to talk to you about this cutie little bag. I don't think I have told you guys before in any of the vlogs or on my Insta stories. I picked this bag up from the Decathlon store, which is in Ambattur. If you guys live in Chennai, you know where the store is. Otherwise, I will try and find a link in the description. Otherwise, I'll try and find a link and leave it in the description box below. So this is a small cute little bag that I do carry. It's nice and neon in color. So even if you do take your bike out in the night, the neon is going to pop out a little bit, which lets you be seen a little more in the night, hopefully. So another thing that I wanted to talk to you about is accessories on the bike. I've not yet been picking up too many accessories. I don't even have a speedometer as yet, so I rely on Strava completely. I'll show you how I go through the Strava app in a second, but I don't totally use a speedometer or any other meters as of now. It's just I keep pacing myself while I'm cycling, and I try to concentrate on doing longer distances more than speed as of now. Maybe short bursts, a little bit of a 200 meter sprint, 100 meter sprint in between if I feel like it, providing there is absolutely no traffic. Otherwise, that is out of the question. But I'm just trying to build more cycling endurance. The chain cleaner should have done its job by now. And now we go to the chain lube. So I use the same method even while applying chain lube. But what I do is, once I'm done with the chain, I do try to get a little bit into the crank. Please do not judge me, the cycle definitely needs to go for a service. One bad thing about this entire thing, using lubes like this is because there is so much of residue left over on the crank and on the frame itself, it picks up dust very easily. Yeah, that's a lot of dust. It definitely has to go in for a service. So one of the comments in one of my videos that I posted, somebody was asking me why have I not been using clipless pedals. Okay, the thing with me and clipless pedals is I do know quite a few people that have been using clipless pedals. I think Anand Uncle also uses, he's the only person that I know who uses them consistently. I've seen a couple of crashes happen where people have not been able to put their foot down in time. especially due to traffic. And I think if they weren't using clipless pedals, they might have escaped, and there've been pretty bad crashes as well. So I'm not yet comfortable enough while riding inside the city to use clipless pedals, even though it's in the morning or in the evening or whatever it is. It's just a little skeptical, that's just my point of view. But if you were riding on, say, a highway where there's not too much of oncoming traffic or people trying to cut across you, then maybe yes, definitely I would try out clipless pedals. But as of now, I'm sticking to my normal pedals. Okay, so this is the Strava app that I use. And basically what Strava is, it helps you keep a track of how many kilometers you've done, what's your average speed, what is your top speed that you did. It gives you your complete ride history. So even if you do not have a speedometer or any other meter to calculate the amount of speed you've done or the amount of kilometers that you have covered in your cycle ride, you can always log on to Strava. I think the trial version is absolutely free. But then once you start paying for it and stuff like that, you get a lot more benefits added to it. I'm still on the basic Strava plan. Okay, so here goes nothing. Basically, I am riding with one hand, I have the camera in the other. Bloody hell!
That's a lot of smoke. Yeah, this is why I like cycling during the morning. Not less smoke and dust. This is the Nuavi road. Quite a few people out and about. And yeah, yesterday was a full lockdown day.
And today everybody is back at it.
Signal. Hopefully nobody cuts across the signal and cuts across me. And we made it across without any issues.
So if you guys do like this video and think the effort is good enough to share this with you all, smash that thumbs up button or subscribe to my channel, or do both, preferably.
But yeah man, this ride's turning out to be a little crazy.
That's the helmet, by the way. Okay, so right now I am on top of one of my most favorite spots in the city while I'm doing my short ride route, and behind me the sun is setting and the view, except for this traffic, is actually pretty spectacular. Okay, so the sun is setting now, it is time to head back home, but before that, this is the skyline on the other side, and that is a train by the ICF that has not yet been set out into India to journey the country. Check that out. That is the Sarvana Stores. It is a mammoth of a building. Absolutely mammoth of a building. I'm on top of the flyover and that thing still towers like quite a bit. Okay, time to head back home. I will see you guys in a bit. Okay, do you see the blue engine that's going right behind? That is an engine that's either come for a service or is being tested. Check that out. Well, this is the absolutely new train. And there are a whole bunch of doggies playing around over there. Territorial fight. No fighting. I wish Arun were here right now to have a look at the train. He is absolutely crazy about trains.
So I'm almost back home now and it is time to stop Strava. One really good thing about Strava is, even though you are like stationary at one particular point of time, it calculates your moving time, so the amount of time standing still is not going to affect your average moving time and speed time. That's how it works. And once you're done, all you have to do is hit the finish button and say save activity.
Takes time to calculate.
Okay, so I am signing out from this vlog. I will see you in the next one. Bye bye guys, and if you do have any comments, please do leave your comments in the comment section below, and I will definitely get back to you as soon as possible. Bye bye, see you.